Welcome back, or welcome to all you lovely, lovely people out there. Tonight, we're going to be doing the last video, but certainly not the least, in our Zodiac Element series. So, for tonight's video, we're going to be doing Earth Triggers. For all of you earth signs out there, I think I actually saw most of the comments in this series of earth signs, so there's a lot of you out there and you've all been waiting for this video, so I hope you enjoy it. I did get together what I think are some fun triggers, and as always, I'll give you a little bit of background on all you earth signs. I am in no way an expert, so if it looks like I'm reading, I am reading off some stuff I wrote down. I'll give you a little bit of that background and we'll get into our triggers, okay? Let's get started. Alright, everyone. So, as I've mentioned in my previous videos for this series, just because this is labeled for all of you earth elements out there, that doesn't mean that the rest of you can't enjoy these triggers, okay? Anyone can enjoy them. I was just specifically labeling them for your zodiac signs. So everyone watching, please sit back and relax and enjoy these earth triggers, okay? Now, to give you a little bit of that background, if you're not sure if your sign is an earth element or not, the earth elements of the zodiac or astrology are Capricorns, Taurus, and Virgo. Now, you earth signs or earth elements out there, you're often oriented towards what is real. You often are very productive, and you're usually practical or grounded and the more dependable of the zodiac signs. You guys don't typically take big risks and prefer to take the routes that are a sure thing. Those in the earth elements, you typically feel best when you've accumulated a good number of like worldly possessions that are special to you. You guys are the building blocks of the zodiac, and you typically like or deal with things in creation, such as like building up your job or building up your home or designing a comfortable room. Stuff like that. You guys have a sense of duty, responsibility, and reliability. And you're the people that the other zodiac signs can count on. However, because of these traits, you earth elements out there can sometimes become like workaholics and can be often stubborn. So you can be so caught up in your objective that you might overlook the feelings of others. So, in this video, I've gathered some nice and relaxing earth-oriented triggers for you to help ease the quaking mind of you earth signs, okay? All right. Go ahead and close your eyes, sit back, and we'll get started. Okay, shenanigans. So, we're going to start with one of the most popular earth triggers, and personally, one of my favorite earth triggers, and one that you guys request a lot on my live streams. We're going to do some wood tapping. I've gathered an assortment of different wooden objects, and we're just going to tap and scratch on them and hopefully help you to get some tingles, 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 tingles. Okay, let's get started. Yeah. Let's switch to our next wooden object. Next, we have this massager. Okay. We'll move on to our next object. You all know that I'm from Michigan, so here is my wooden Michigan cutting board. Let's go on to our next wooden trigger. Okay, so for our next wooden trigger, I have this cake stand. It actually cracked, but my dad fixed it for me. So I like rustic looks of things. I got this wooden cake stand. Okay. Let's move on to our last wooden trigger. I have this cute little wooden toad or frog. I got him at this cute little earth store. I was going out of business, sadly. He's just so cute. I haven't named him yet. If you want to suggest a name for my little toad, go ahead and comment it below. Comes with this cute little wooden implement, and you run it along his spine as like an instrument. I think it sounds kind of cool. Okay. I'm not sure how relaxing that is. I just really wanted to play with it. And I felt like this was a good excuse. Alright. Let's go ahead and move on to our next Earth Elements trigger. Okay, lovelies. Next, I have this mortar and pestle. And I love that it looks like there's little tree branches all over it. I thought it fit with the earth theme very well. It is made out of stone. in the handle. It's made of wood. I grabbed some herbs and I thought we could do some grinding in the mortar and pestle. That's one of my favorite triggers, and I discovered that sound and that trigger from Ting Ting ASMR when she does her herbal shop role plays. I thought it would be a good earth trigger for us. Go ahead and pour these into the mortar and pestle. Smells so good. It's a mix of different teas that I drink. Okay. Kind of mix that up real quick. Now let's do some crunching. And we'll go ahead and move on to our next Earth trigger. Okay, all you wonderful, lovely shenanigans. For our next Earth Elements trigger, we're going to play and tap on this Himalayan salt lamp. And they're meant to purify the air. So, shenanigans. For this next Earth Elements trigger, I have some pretty fake flowers and fake leaves that we can play with. It is winter in Michigan, so it's kind of hard for me to find any real flowers or leaves, so I figured fake would be fine. So sit back and relax, and we'll get started. Go ahead and switch to the leaves. move on to our second to last Earth Elements trigger. Okay, all of you Earth Elements out there. Next, I have this bag of stones. We're just going to tap and scratch on. You can see, bag of stones. I love that sound they make when they all rub together. Gonna grab one here. Okay, let's move on to our last Earth trigger. So for our last Earth Elements trigger, I have this mini Zen garden And we're just going to set this up together. Okay, so let's open it up. Inside, we have this cute little bridge. We have a shrine. Oh, there we go. Shrine. We have the rake. Some pebbles. And our bag of sand. Underneath is our sun garden. So, let's go ahead and pour in the sand.